Today I'll be talking on the fourth source of knowledge or reality, and that is religion. I already spoke on science and spirituality. Science uses senses, experiment, observation. Spirituality uses intuition, which is mysticism, which is your direct experience. Spirituality may be religious or it may not be religious. So today I'll be speaking on the third source of knowledge, or the third source of reality, or the third approach to reality. The fourth one is philosophy, which is the rational approach, using your mind, your thinking, that I will discuss later. So today my focus is religion. Now, what is the tool of religion? The tool of religion is revelation. In Arabic, we call it wahi, revelation, reveal. When the things are revealed from God to a prophet, and then the prophet conveys that message to people. Like in philosophy, you use your mind, your rationality, your reason, logic. In science, you use your senses. You observe, then you conduct experiments. In intuition or mysticism or spirituality, that is insight, that is direct experience, to which we may call ilham or ihsan. But religion is revelation, that is revealed. Now, what is religion? The word religion is religare, from Latin word, which means to join together. Okay, to join together human being with God. And the definition of religion is that it is the sum total of faith, worship, and morality. You have faith in supernatural entity or entities, because there are monotheistic religions like Judaism, Christianity, Islam, which think monotheistic. Mono means one, theistic, theo means God, one God. That the supernatural entity is one. And there may be polytheistic, which means poly means many, multi, many gods. So there are Abrahamic religions are three, Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. Religion is faith that you believe. Then to demonstrate, to manifest your belief, you do some rituals, some actions, practices, and those practices are called worship. Different religions have different modes of worship. Like Jews, they go to synagogue and they may perform different rituals. Christians, they go to church. And Muslims, they go to mosque. And their concept of worship, like the five pillars, which is Tawheed, oneness of God, Shahada, saying the Kalma, La ilaha illallah, Muhammadur Rasulullah, and then prayer, Salat, five times prayer, and then fasting, Ramadan, and Zakat, the charity, and pilgrimage, Hajj. So these are the five pillars. These are the acts of worship. You demonstrate your link with God. There are so many religions in the world. Like the oldest religion is Hinduism, which is number three in the number of followers, like almost 10% of the humanity follow Hinduism. Hinduism, the word Hindu, that is from Sindhu, the Indus River. So the people who were living on the sides of Indus River, their religion, our way of life, or the social way of life, that is Hinduism. Hinduism has the concept of many gods, but the basic beliefs of the Hinduism, for example, ahimsa, non-violence, no violence, peace, and for example, dharma. Dharma is the duties and the ethics. And then there is kama. Kama. Kama is desires. And then karma. Karma, intentions are consequences. And then moksha. Moksha is liberation. Liberation of the soul. Liberty, freedom. So these are different concepts of Hinduism, different beliefs of Hinduism. Then another religion, Jainism. Jainism, the word Jainism, that is also in India. Jainism is taken from the word Jina. Okay, Jina. So Jina, that is victor, victory. Like there were 24 Mahavira, the last one. Was their famous religious figures, and they control, that is extreme, you may call it simply the extreme form of, because the Brahmacharya is celibacy, like no sexual relationship, and that is complete ahimsa, complete non-violence, and metempsychosis, generations, that there are different janam, different, the transmigration, that once you die, and then you, the rebirth, you are born again, and then how to get rid of these cycles of rebirths. So that is Jainism. They even don't kill like insects or, they are totally, totally non-violent Jains. Then we have Buddhism. Buddhism doesn't have the concept of God, a supernatural entity. There is no concept of God, but still it is religion. And their main focus, that is on nirvana, that you discover your insight, yourself, and there are different concepts like tantra. So you can discover your own self, then you get rid of your desires, okay? You completely control your wishes, and then you get nirvana, which is the final freedom from all these human weaknesses and human desires. That is Buddhism. Similarly, we have Confucianism, which is from Confucius. So Confucianism, there, the concept that secular is sacred. Secular is sacred. The things which are secular, which are day-to-day activities of our life, like our family, our work, our day-to-day activities, these are sacred, these are holy. We should not keep in mind like heaven or hell, that we should do good acts for heaven or for hell because of fear, because of hereafter, because of the life after death. But this life, each and every activity of this life is sacred, that is holy. So this is the main concept of Confucianism, which is in China. In China, we have another religion, which is Taoism. Tao. Tao is root, the way. The way of salvation, focus on day-to-day activities. In Japan, for example, there is another religion which is called Shintoism. Shinto, God. Their different ceremonies and their activities, how to show their to their deity or many deities. That is Shintoism. And the importance of ancestors. That ancestors are very important. The people who were in the past, they are very, very important for us. Our ancestors. That is the concept of Shintoism. Then we have Judaism, which is based on the Old Testament, the Torah, and their sacred figure, that is Moses. Christianity. The Christianity is mainly Christ, Jesus Christ. Christianity is in the world, this is number one in the, if we're talking about the numbers of followers, like 30% or 33% of the humanity follow Christianity. So in Christianity, then we have Catholicism, and then we have Protestant Christians, and then we have Orthodox Christians, and their main focus is on Christ. So that is based on a figure, Jesus Christ. And for example, Orthodox, and Catholics. In Catholics, they're more focused on Mary, the mother of Jesus Christ. And they have their 10 commandments, which are very similar to other religions also, like don't kill or don't tell lies, or, you know, these are 10 commandments. And Bible. Christians, they believe in the Old Testament, also in the New Testament. Both parts of the Bible they believe. Jews only believe in the Old Testament, not in the New Testament. So after Christianity, the next religion, that was Islam. Now the word Islam, etymology, origin of the word of Islam is from the root salam. Salam is, it has different like connotations or meanings, which may mean submission. It may mean peace, like salam, salam alaikum. And it may mean salim, like wholeness. So there are different meanings of the word Islam, but usually it is taken in the meaning of submission to the will of God. And the concept of God, the word God, which is Allah in Arabic, and the Muslims use the word Allah for that supernatural entity. So in Islam, monotheism is unqualified. Like in Christianity, they believe in God and in one God, but they have the concept of Trinity, that there are three gods in one God and one in three and three in one. They consider the Holy Ghost, Mary, and Jesus Christ, or the Father, is three in one and one in three. That is called Thaslis or Trinity. So that is monotheism, but qualified. In Islam, it is unqualified. There is no, you cannot mix any other concept with the monotheism. So this is the purest form of oneness or unity of God, which is the basic belief of Muslims. In Judaism is also monotheistic, but there the difference is in the prophethood. Jews, they believe in Moses. Christians believe in Christ and Moses, and Muslims, they believe in Muhammad. That Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that is the final messenger, the final prophet from God. And he completed this Abrahamic, or from the Adam to the Muhammad, this whole sequence or series of prophets was completed by the prophet Muhammad. So this is not Muhammadanism, like Christianity is by Christ. The Christ is the central figure. But in Islam, Allah is the central figure and Muhammad was his messenger. But Muhammad, the difference in Christianity is about the Jesus Christ, we know very little things, like 2-3 years we know about his life. And the life of Muhammad, that is completely recorded in books, and also Quran refers to his life. So when we study Islam academically, so the personality of the prophethood is also very important. He is an individual who was an honest man, a trustworthy person before he became prophet. And his treatment of the slaves, his family, his wives, his companions, you know, he is like a role model as an individual. Also, for example, as a military strategist, he was a commander. He organized military campaigns against the enemies of Islam at that time, like the Battle of Ditch, Ahzab, in which he did military strategy, how to save the city of Medina. And then there are so many other battles. And he was a diplomat. Like, he wrote many letters to other emperors or kings or rulers at that time in a very diplomatic way. And he was also a peacemaker. When he conquered Mecca, so he didn't kill everybody. And that was not the time of revenge. At that time, we see that he was rahmatul lil alameen, that he was mercy for the people. He didn't declare, okay, now today I have the day, so my revenge. So his at that time, we see a person who is a very, very good peacemaker. And then before that, Sulay Hudaybiyah, he has been seen as a very good negotiator. And then as a teacher, when he would guide his followers, so the way he used to guide his followers, that was quite impressive. He used the principles of pedagogy and psychology and human understanding and human resource development. So at that, if we see to his figure in, from that point of view, so he is totally different from other prophets. Because Islam, as it claims, that that's the final message. So the final message must be, must give all the basic details of the human life. So that is the difference between religion and deen. Okay, deen. Inna deena inda Allahul Islam means that religion or system is Islam. Now, religion is just your faith and your worship and morality. But deen has another concept which means that it may encompass other aspects of life. That Quran and the sources of Islamic Sharia or law, Quran, Hadith, Ijma, Ijtihad, which is like, you know, if according to the new situations, if Muslims have to consider the new situations, so then they do, there is an institution of Ijtihad. Ijtihad may not be confused with Jihad. Jihad is struggle, struggle against your own desires, which is a spiritual concept, as well as a battle when there is, you know, a Muslim state, and then under the command of a leader, there is organized army, not like jihad is the duty of each and every person. So there is a concept of jihad, which is a battle, the holy war, and at the same time, there is a concept of jihad, which is more spiritual, that is more insight. So the concept of morality is very, very important. Islam like starts from individual, taqwa, righteousness, piety, that you individual become like very strong. And then it goes to family. The institution of family is very, very important in Islam. And then from family, society, and all this has the underpinnings of morality, ethics. As in philosophy, there is theology. So in religion also there is theology. So the similarly there is also ethics in religion and ethics in philosophy. Ethics can be religious or it can be irreligious. So there is religious morality, that this is good and this is bad. This is haram and this is halal. This is permitted and this is forbidden. So that has moral underpinnings to the human being should become moral, conscience. Islam makes you conscious, and at the same time, it creates you know, awareness of your conscience, of your moral responsibilities. So this moral responsibility is also important in governance. When you become like a political leader, and you by consultative process, when you are elected or selected by Shura, and you govern the political affairs, so for that, then you need again morality, because if you are not morally strong, you will be not a very good ruler. So Islam prepares you from individual, then family, society, and politics, economics. There is also economics, and in this whole paradigm, the basic concept that is morality, that the main topic that we see in Quran, that is human being to teach to human being the ideal life, that you can be the ideal person, and how if you follow morality, that is very important. Then there are different beliefs in Islam, like zalikal kitabo la riba fihi hudal lil muttaqin allazina yu'minuna bil ghaib wa yuqimuna salata wa mimma razaqnahum yunfiqun. So here it is the basic, the first, the start in the Holy Quran, in the volume of the Holy Quran. So ghaib, like you believe in unseen, the unseen is God, Allah, then the angels and the hereafter, life after death, which is unseen. Similarly, then we have, you have different modes of worship, as already I explained. And then you have also amantu billahi wa malaikatihi wa kutubihi wa rasulihi. So book, Quran, all books which were revealed to other, and then Quran, which is the final book, and all messengers from Adam to Muhammad, but Muhammad was the final one. So, and the life after death, the hereafter, that this life is not the final stage, there will be another stage, and that will be after death. So this is the belief system and then the worship system. So Islam then have the five pillars, which is Islam, Iman, which is the belief system, and Ihsan, which is excellence, when you become like spiritually conscious and you understand yourself and you understand your God. So some people call it tasawwuf or Sufism. So this is, you know, the combination of Islamic system. Now, why Islam? Why not other religions? So there are some distinguishing features of Islam, like its concept of monotheism, which is very simple, and its belief system is very clear, and its morality that is very strong. But in spite of this, Muslims in the world, they are like number two in the world, like almost 20% of the humanity, that they are Muslims. But politically, they are not strong, and their natural resources, they are not like exploiting, and economically, there is poverty. So these are, you know, different political, economic, and socioeconomic problems that the Muslims are facing. So as a student of Islam, you should also understand the world of Islam, that there are 58 countries and their political, economic, and other conditions. Why we need religion? We need religion because science has its limits, philosophy has its limits, and spirituality has its limits. So we need to understand the fundamental questions of human being, that who am I, where from I came, where I will go, who is my creator, who is the creator of this universe, and who sustains me, and who to whom should I seek guidance and help and assistance. So to solve all these basic problems, which we don't get the answers in science, spirituality, and philosophy, so then we need religion for all these things. And then there are so many religions, but Islam is one of the religions, and according to Muslims, that is the only true religions. So then you have to seek understanding of Islam in that concept. Why science is limited? Because senses are limited. Senses, we can feel and touch things which are visible, part of the matter. And then mysticism, that is personal experience, that's inside. And philosophy, so mind, intellectual capacity, rationality, that is also limited. Some things logically or rationally, you cannot, like the concept of God, where from we came, life, the start, the commencement of life, and the end of life, and after that. So to solve these questions, then we need religion. This was my introductory video on religion and Islam. I will continue this discussion. Basically, this is academic discussion. And today I wanted to focus on religion, which is the third source or one of the four sources of knowledge and reality. We will continue. Please ask questions to understand religion and the religion of Islam. And we don't use the word mazhab. And there is no word mazhab in Quran. So the word which is in Quran, that is deen. And deen is different from religion because religion focuses only on your beliefs and your faith and your worship modes, sometimes morality. But deen then gives these three, they apply the applications of these three and other aspects of life, then it becomes more comprehensive. So we will remain in touch, and I try to prove that for the answering fundamental questions of life and human being, we need religion. Thank you very much.